In the previous lecture, we saw the characteristics of an ideal transformer. In this lecture, we will see the Phasor diagram of an ideal transformer. Let's consider an ideal transformer which has no winding resistance, no leakage reactance, no copper or I2R loss, and no core loss. And let's say it is equipped with primary side being connected to alternating voltage source V1 and secondary side is open. So in the primary side, this alternating voltage V1 will cause an alternating current in the primary winding. For ideal transformer, primary coil is a purely inductive, and also as the secondary is open, output is zero. So current drawn by the primary winding will be magnetizing current I mu. This magnetizing current I mu is very small in magnitude. The current is purely inductive as it flows through the inductive primary coils of the ideal transformer. So this current will lag the alternating voltage V1 by angle of 90 degree. If we consider the permeability is constant, then this current produces an alternating flux phi mt, which is proportional to the current in phase with the current. And using the current flow, the direction of the flux can be determined by Thumb's rule, which gives the flux direction in the upward direction. The alternating flux phi mt is linked by both primary and secondary winding. Due to this flux linking, an induced EMF is generated in each winding. The EMF generated in the primary winding is known as self-induced EMF or E1 due to the self-induction, and the EMF generated in the secondary winding is known as mutually induced EMF or E2 due to the mutual induction. Now this induced EMF E1 is better known as self-induced EMF, and it is equal to the alternating supply voltage V1 at every instant of time, and it is also in phase opposition with the alternating supply voltage V1. So we can write E1 is equal to minus V1. This relation can be explained by Lenz's law, which states that the direction of current induced in a conductor by a changing magnetic field is such that the magnetic field created by the induced current opposes the initial changing magnetic field which produced it. So induced EMF E1 should oppose the cause of its own, and induced EMF E1 is generated due to the electromagnetic induction of the alternating flux phi mt. The alternating flux phi mt is generated due to the magnetizing current I mu, and the magnetizing current I mu is generated due to the supply voltage V1. So the self-induced voltage E1 should oppose the supply voltage V1, or in other words, we can say E1 is equal to minus V1. Now this supply induced EMF E1 is proportional to the number of turns in the primary winding or N1 and the rate of change of flux or d phi mt by dt. So we can write the self-induced EMF E1 is equal to minus N1 into d phi mt by dt. Induced EMF E2. The induced EMF E2 is called the mutually induced EMF. Similar to the self-induced EMF E1, it is also antiphase with the alternating supply voltage V1. If there is no loss in the case of ideal transformer, then we can say that this induced voltage E2 will be equal to the voltage across the load or V2. And the magnitude of this induced EMF E2 is proportional to the number of turns in the secondary winding or N2 and the rate of change of flux d phi m by dt. So E2 is equal to minus N2 into d phi mt divided by dt. This relationship between the flux phi mt and both EMFs is that both EMF E1 and E2 lacks the alternating flux phi mt by an angle of 90 degree. And this alternating flux phi mt is common to both of the windings, i.e. primary and secondary, as the flux links with both windings and induces EMF respectively. Both EMF E1 and E2 are in phase with each other. Now, let's see some mathematical equation for this ideal transformer with no load condition. Now this magnetizing current I mu t is equal to maximum current I mu into sin omega t, and alternating flux phi m t is equal to maximum flux phi m into sin omega t. Self-induced EMF or E1 is equal to N1 into d phi m by dt. And if we put the value of phi m t, then this will result in E1 is equal to N1 into omega into cos omega t. This mutual induced EMF E2 is equal to N2 d phi m t by dt, and if we put the value of phi m t as phi m sin omega t, then this will result in E2 is equal to N2 omega cos omega t. Now the ratio of both of the EMF or E2 by E1 is equal to N2 omega cos omega t divided by N1 omega cos omega t, which will result in N2 by N1, which is equal to K, and this K is known as the voltage transformation ratio. This is only valid for the ideal transformer, where E2 by E1 is equal to N2 by N1 is equal to K. Now we can find out the relationship between the E2 and E1 from this K or voltage transformation ratio. And we know that E1 is equal to minus V1. And from here, we can determine E2 as K into E1. So we can write E2 is equal to minus K into V1. Now, let's draw the Phasor diagram for this ideal transformer with no load condition. At first, you will take the flux phi mt as reference. Both EMF E1 and E2 are in phase with each other, and they both lag the reference flux phi mt by an angle of 90 degree. Both EMF E1 and E2 are anti-phase with the supply alternating voltage V1, so they are 180 degree out of phase with the supply alternating voltage V1. That's why this self-induced voltage E1 is equal to minus V1 and this mutually induced voltage E2 is equal to minus K into V1. Depending upon this voltage transformation ratio K, this E1 can be greater than E2 or E2 can be greater than E1. Magnetizing current I mu is purely inductive. In other words, it will lag the supply alternating voltage V1 by an angle of 90 degree and it will be very small in magnitude. So this is the Phasor diagram for the ideal transformer with no load condition. In the next lecture, we will see the Phasor diagram for the ideal transformer with loaded condition
and
with resistive load.
This concludes our discussion for this lecture. In the event that you have any question regarding this presentation, feel free to post them in the comment section and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.